Hello everyone and welcome to the channel. Sve rečenice u engleskom moraju imati subjekt. Međutim, ponekad nijedan subjekt nije odmah vidljiv i u tim situacijama koristimo riječi it ili there. Ovo se ponekad naziva lažni subjekt. It je zamjenica trećeg lica i često je koristimo da govorimo o vremenu. Mi kažemo it is hot, it is 3 o'clock. It is raining. Iako bi značenje ovih rečenica bilo jasno i bez zamjenice it, nije je moguće izostaviti jer gramatički ove rečenice ne bi bile ispravne zato što nemaju subjekt. Primjeri kada je it lažni subjekt.
It's going to be windy tomorrow and it is going to snow. It's cold and a bit rainy, and it might be freezing at night. It's always sunny in Dubai in the winter. It's 2 miles to the nearest station. It isn't good to eat too much chocolate. It is important to be honest with one another. It isn't safe to walk alone at night.
Kada želimo naglasiti da nešto postoji na određenom mjestu, koristimo strukturu there is u jednini ili there are za množinu. Za prošlo vrijeme koristimo strukture there was i there were, a za buduće there will be i there is going to be. Ovi oblici postoje i u negativnim i upitnim rečenicama. There won't be, neće biti. There wasn't, nije bilo. I tako dalje.
There is nothing we can do. There will be peace on earth. There is something we need to discuss. There were 50 people at the club. There were not many people in the stadium because of the rain. Is there anything we can do to help? Is there a problem with email today? Is there a basketball game on TV tonight? Were there many people at the party?
There se također koristi sa modalnim glagolima. Primjer.
There must be some way out of here. There should be no problem if you follow the guidelines. There might be some delay in response. There can be miracles when you believe. Could there be life on other planets? Should there be more security in schools?
Razlika između there is i have. Struktura there is, there are, je bezlična, što znači da ne uzima subjekt prije sebe. Naprimjer, there is a book on the shelf. Međutim, glagol to have uvijek ima subjekt ispred sebe. I have 2 cars, gdje I je subjekt. Da kažemo there are 3 bedrooms in the house je ispravno. Reći the house has 3 bedrooms je također ispravno. Ali nepravilno je započeti rečenicu sa have u engleskom bez subjekta. Have 3 bedrooms in the house je neispravno.
If you liked this video, please subscribe. That's all for today. Thanks for watching.